Hi, you know about the Facebook newsfeed?
Sure.
So,
So I think Facebook Newsfeed. Yep.
yeah, go ahead.
So I think, sure. I think it's about people can follow other friends. It's a place like may clarify a little bit that people can follow other friends, and people can maybe follow some organizations like some like CNN or Fox, this kind of news organizations. And so people can get the latest post from them. It's like maybe a smaller post, and this post can either contain a picture or contains a video. But I think this is like we people can follow with each other, and people can see, like in his home timeline, people can see those kind of latest posts from those followers.
Okay, so that's what I actually would like you to design. I would like to design Facebook newsfeed feature. Let's
Got
say
it.
a user has a Facebook account and he has some friends, and whatever his friends update, I would like the user to see those updates in his homepage. Okay.
Got it. Sure. No problem. So may I go ahead and maybe put down some of the requirements here?
Yes.
So sure. Go ahead. Requirements. The first is so people can I'll leave out the login logout part, but people can follow person like a friend.
So is it a friendship relation or is it a follower relation?
It's a follower relation.
Okay, so it's
My
only possible that
understanding.
I can follow you, but you cannot follow me, or it's like a two-way. Like if I follow you, you will be following me as well.
Actually, I think it's similar like Instagram or Twitter that we just if I follow you, I see your message. But you cannot see mine, but please correct me if I'm wrong here. So it's like a single relation. Is
Okay.
that
So
correct or
usually in Facebook it's different. Like once, like let's say if I'm friend with you, it means you also friend with me. Okay. But of course we can control.
I see. I see.
Yeah.
It's like
But
friend
we
request. It's like got it. So maybe yeah, I can change it here actually. You also can establish friendship with person, with other person.
Yeah. I mean, right now, just for simplification, we can say, okay, whatever the relationship is, it will be two ways. Otherwise, right now in Facebook, every user has a way to actually filter, like have to have a way to classify or categorize different friends.
Got it. Got it. Right. Makes sense. And then people this way will be request and accept. And then people can follow some public I think it's called public organization or
No, so usually what happens on
pages.
Facebook is there are pages. Yeah, there are pages and the people can like or follow pages. And also in the same way, there are groups as well where people can follow or be part of some groups.
Got it. Right.
Okay. But my focus is mostly on, let's suppose right now we are just focusing on one thing, which is that I would like a user to just see in his newsfeed page or the home page, all the other updates that his friends are doing.
Got it. Makes sense. So people can see in his the activities other or public pages. And so people here, I think when people can follow, you should be able to unfollow. And here, if people can also people can also unfriend, cancel,
Yes.
remove the friendship. Yep. And so Maybe I can put one more is people can like a page or something, then we can, if we had time, we can discuss about this as yeah, well, like like, unlike a post. So that's currently, I think, the some of the functional requirements. If I want to go with I'll go with some non-functional that one is the system should be highly available and fault tolerant. And I think we'll go with, we try to do lower latency possible if for the home timeline, for a home page to generate all the posts. And so we want to go with eventual consistency for the home timeline or the home page, so that home page generation, which is so when people post something new and these people can, I think, eventually see it. So we might not guarantee that you will instantly see it, and different people may see differently, but we can guarantee some eventual there consistency there. And actually, I want to ask a further question. Should we go ahead to implement some, should we put the, I think, user page into the requirements, like user can click a friend or click a public pages to see all of that posts.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's add that as well. And we can see whether if we have time to discuss or not.
Sure. User can click into friends public pages and see the posts. Shall we go ahead and do the capacity estimation, or do you think we can skip that part? For me, either is fine. Yeah.
So what do you think from the Facebook perspective, like how many users do you expect?
To me, I expect, I'm thinking to be 200 million daily active users, mm-hmm. and with 1 million daily posts.
Mm-hmm.
So if I go with 200 million, if I, for the read traffic, I'm thinking it will be a read heavy traffic. Mm-hmm. So if for 200 million daily active users, let's say if each user see his own timeline 5 times a day,
mm-hmm.
and if each user and check some other like friends or public activities, like maybe also 5 times a day. So each user will read the pages 10 times a day. Mm-hmm. And maybe one read, it will include 20 tweets. So let me put it down here. So 200.
I mean, that's fine. We don't need to go into actual storage estimation, but one question for me, which I would like to ask.
Yep.
So you know that, let's say, there will be a lot of posts that will be happening every day, almost every day, and people might be sharing some videos or pictures as well. So it means, of course, we need a lot of storage requirements. So how do you think Facebook can handle all this storage requirement that we need?
You mean, how Facebook handle that large amount of storage?
Yes.
Like for those videos or for those pictures?
Yes.
Got it. I think it should be using those object storage or using the like video those places like object storage to store the videos,
mm-hmm.
and that place might need to be replicated, but I think each video will be put in those places.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. Let's go further. We don't need to do the capacity estimation.
Okay, got it. Sure. So. I think I'll go ahead and list down some of the APIs.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So APIs will, for example, we can go with request friend. I think first this will be user login, and then request friendship. Just login, I think. request friendship. So we'll be also token and friendship. The other user ID. So this one will be home timelines, user token, and yep. So and we can optionally, like if we support multiple devices, we can put a page size, which is optional.
Okay, but like, what is timestamp?
Timestamp is I'm thinking that for example, if I have already read 20 tweets or 20 posts from the homepage, so I want to continue on, so I can provide a timestamp from the last places, so that give me a further like 20 posts from there, from that timestamp.
So it's not a timestamp, it's sort of a page token something, or some query token which every page return, and then you can actually use that one.
I see, got it. So it's like a, okay, I think I can improve there further here. So it's like
a timestamp is something which means that this is basically something related to time. It's not that case easy. Yes or no?
I think because when we store the each tweet, we can have a like what is the current time for that. So each tweet will be corresponding to a time. And then we generated the timeline for them. We can discuss that further using the cache. So we'll cache the time for that tweet as well. So that once we start from, for example, once we start from further, we'll always put the latest, the tweet with latest time first, and then we can input a timestamp, like a string, like in the normal time format, and then we'll search from there further.
Okay, so you are thinking about generating the timeline in always ascending order of time. That's the case.
I think so. Yeah, I think so. We can. Yeah. So I can go ahead further. So user timeline. So user token. And then this is the user ID of the one I want to see. Or, and also the also maybe a page token should be more appropriate, or timestamp, yeah, page sites.
So this is a bit confusing. In one API you are using timestamp, and in the other API you are using page token.
Right. I think maybe I'll just use timestamp for now. Maybe we can, if it's not appropriate, we can maybe later correct it. So I think maybe I'll go with the timestamp for now, and let's see.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, that's fine. I think this is fine. I think maybe you can give me the overall, maybe high level diagram,
or sure, architecture, yeah, or sure,
how, yep, the system would look like.
Sure. So let me ship. Sure. So I'll list out the services. I think first we'll have a routing service. And then we'll be having a, okay. So and next we'll be having a, I think user login service. And then we'll be having a user friendship service.
What information the service will store?
I think user friendship service will be will be handling the request friendship and accept friendship here. So I think mainly we'll be storing, there will be a friendship table, okay, behind it. So like user friendship table. So we'll have a friend, two user IDs as a like user ID. This is a two user which become friends as primary key, and mm-hmm, timestamp as a timestamp here as an entry.
So let's say if a user A send a request to user B, so what we will do, we will just create one entry in this table?
Right, actually, So let me think about this a little further. So I think we might need to specify add another status here actually. So because this friendship, we don't know whether the other guy, for example, if person A requests a friendship to B, we don't know whether the other guy accepted or not. So I think we probably need add a status field so that if this guy can handling whether it's a pending request or accepted. So okay. When user A requests a friend, requests B friendship, so we'll insert an entry here. We're saying that this is a timestamp and this status is pending. And this friendship will insert an entry here. And then once user B accepted, we can update the status being, let's say it's being accepted. So we know user A and user B has been in the friendship already.
Okay.
And yes. And okay, maybe I think I'll go ahead further and list down the other services, and maybe we can discuss a little bit how to scale this kind of this database or.
Yeah, okay, that's fine.
Uh-huh. So, and the other one will be user friendship service. And the other one will be having a home timeline service. And then the there will be a post service here. So post service will be handling a similar table that will be having a I think we for user login service, I think we also need to store the user info. For example, what is the user, whether it's a public pages, whether it's a person or a type. I think this kind of user info will also need to store in this user login service here. So I think maybe I can add this one as well. So like user ID, which is a PK. And then we will add the user type, like name and email, and we add the last login and create it. So this will be two timestamp for this user. And this will be handled behind the user login service. So post service, let me go back here. Post service will be handled, where we have will be a post ID, which is a PK. And publisher and the user ID and content, and there will be maybe a image or video URL if needed, and we'll have a timestamp created time, and let me see. Yep. So I think I'll go with this entry for now and see further need to expand some more columns.
Okay, that's fine.
And we'll go with home timeline service. So home timeline service, this will be this service will be responsible for, so the post service will be responsible for handling the new posts and for creating a new post. And then this home timeline service will be responsible for generating the home timeline for each user. So for home timeline service, there will be also a user timeline service below. So for this two service, I think we can go with two models. One is a pull model and the other one is a push model. So I think for they both have pros and cons. I think for the pull model, I think it might be easier. We'll just read from the DB and we cache it. And I think the cons of it is that because we don't know what is the correct pull cadence. For example, the first thing is user only gets update when he refresh screen or when he actually pull it. If he doesn't pull it, he will never know that the other guy has made a new post.